Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida. This is the National Football League. Taking on Cam Newton and the New England Patriots.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida as a moment ago the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with Cam Newton and the New England Patriots. This across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. The Dolphins offense set to take over, and it's the longtime veteran Ryan Fitzpatrick who leads the way.
Ryan Fitzpatrick is the kind of guy you want on your team in every situation, whether you want him to be your starter, whether you want him to bridge and help a rookie out like Tua Tagovailoa. It doesn't matter. He can fit every spot you're looking for. He's in the second year of a two-year deal, went 5-8 and 13 starts last year with 20 touchdown passes. And anytime he's on the field, there could be some Fitz magic.
Here's the first carry from Matt Breida. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags.
Face mask. Defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. Fitzpatrick, a give to Breida. And he works his way forward for about four up to the midfield stripe.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Fitzpatrick now from the 50. He rifles one that's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Patriot defense has a touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Nick Folk for the point after. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is Jakeem Grant. And able to get this out to the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
So Miami coming out for their second drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position of throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
That certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Running out of the gun here, Breida. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Here's Breida. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one? Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. And it's caught by Parker. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 36. This is Breida. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
He was brought down.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack.
A big loss.
Well, we knew this guy wasn't especially fleet of foot, but he tried to conjure up some escapability, but there was no way he was getting away on that one.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. Back deep for the Patriots, Gunnar Olszewski. This one angles out of bounds in a good spot in the Coffin Quarter. They're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line. Out come the New England Patriots, led by their 6'5" veteran quarterback, Cam Newton.
And when he's at the top of his game, you see that big smile? That's when you know everything is clicking. That means he's accurate throwing the football. They can't get him down in the run game. And his team is having a whole lot of fun, because when they score a touchdown, some fan's going to get lucky and get the game ball.
Newton on first down. And his throw is incomplete. N'Keal Harry was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
This is Sony Michel. He grew up a few miles north of here. And this is going to double their room to maneuver, able to get it from the 5 to the 10-yard line. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on 3rd down. Out of the gun, Newton. And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Patriots send out their punter, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Now a fair catch taken just across midfield, maybe by a yard or two. 37 yards on the punt with no return, and it'll be Dolphin football. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
They'll start on the ground with Breida. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. Jason
McCourty. We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's 2nd and 12. Now it's Breida. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of 1 there.
A gain of 1 yard makes it 3rd and 11. That's the end of the first quarter.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Nothing.
Down a nickel formation here defensively. Operating from the gun, Fitzpatrick. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Caught left side, Williams. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
It's a gain of 9.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Throwing Fitzpatrick. He'll drop this off to Larry. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
We often talk about understanding the playbook, understanding progressions, and understanding what the defense is doing. We saw all of that on that play. Great recognition and understood where his running back was going to be. Found a way to have him leak out underneath, hit him with the football, and they picked up the first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Again, it's Fitzpatrick. Looking sideline, incomplete. He was looking for Matt Breida out of the backfield. And now it's second down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. To throw again, Fitzpatrick. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line.
First and goal.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
This will be their first trip to the red zone. They've got it first and goal to go. Now the former Cal Bear, it's Patrick Laird. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the one. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
It is definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
Second and goal from the one. Operating from the gun, Fitzpatrick. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Lawrence Guy able to get in there and drop him for a loss.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Guy get out of his hands quicker.
About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal.
Let's go, team. It's going to be a long day offense. It's going to be a long day.
From the gun, Fitzpatrick. Fine work by the Patriot D there, and it's fourth down.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
So on fourth down, Dolphin kicker Jason Sanders comes on. This just a 24-yard attempt. The kick by Sanders is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
Dolphins 3.
had something of a pick-me-up, but the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put three on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not to solve all their problems either.
After the field goal, here comes Sanders to kick it away. This will be fielded inside the five. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Returns. The Patriots take over first and 10 at their own 27.
So back onto the field come the Pats for their second drive. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Newton and the Patriots with a first and 10 at their own 27. He'll set up to throw from the gun. That's going to be caught. It's Jacoby Myers. A quick first down pickup. Good start after going three and out on their opening drive.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
They'll run it here. This is James White.
And he'll get maybe a couple before he's taken down, as that will take us to the two-minute warning.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8 at the 41-yard line.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. Give him 6 on the play, and that is going to set up a 3rd and 1.
It's a gain of 6, and it's 3rd down.
Here's Newton, and this is going to be incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
The Patriots send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this one goes angling out of bounds, and it will be spotted inside the 30-yard line. Matt Breed in the offense heading back out. He's just been looking for some space. Yeah, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about
him. No, don't take him totally out of the game.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Operating from the gun, Fitzpatrick looking middle, and that's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. 1st down.
At the 46-yard line.
Fitzpatrick, the old war horse, getting everybody up to the line quickly. Looking left side, and it's complete. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. From the gun, Fitzpatrick, and this will be incomplete. physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over, then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. Throwing again, Fitzpatrick. Eluding the pressure right. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. They got to get it to the 21 here on third down. Operating from the gun, Fitzpatrick. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. It'll be spotted on the right hash, a 52-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about 2 out of 3, and this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over, and it's a big kick, but now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong because they have plenty of leg.
And now this throw incomplete, and that is how this first half will come to an end. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. It was an excellent first half from the former league MVP, Cam Newton. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Football from the 6. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The return. The Patriots take over first and 10.
New England trotting into place on offense. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. He was brought down by Kamu Grugier-Hill.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second and 7, Newton. This is White on the screen. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 16 yards, a first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
First down throw for Newton. It's grabbed over the middle by White. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory right at the 40. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end could be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to account for him.
Now a first down carry. It's Michelle. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Again, it's Michelle. And they get to him quickly here as he's stopped right around the 13. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Newton on 3rd down. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. It's Shaq Lawson who worked his way in there to get him down. Just held on to the football too long there, Charles. That's point blank, right?
Yeah, I agree with that totally. You've got to have that internal clock that goes in your head that says either get rid of the football or flush and go and use your legs and try and pick up the first down. I think he hung in there too long, and a blitz got to him.
Here's Nick Folk now on for the field goal. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3.
Dolphins 3.
Well, looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps a deficit very, very manageable. You know, all things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter.
Fielded in the end zone. And this will be a touchback as Grant opts not to return it.
At their own 25-yard line.
And it's player spotlight time. And we shine that spotlight
on Ryan Fitzpatrick. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. They'll begin the drive with Breida. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
On second and nine, Fitzpatrick, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. On third down, Fitzpatrick. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give them 22 there on the third down conversion.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
First and 10, Fitzpatrick. Brought in over the middle by Graham. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
To Jakeem Graham. A gain of 9 brings up 2nd and 1 at the 42-yard line.
Last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, 1st and 10. They go play action. Fitzpatrick. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Devontae Parker was the intended receiver, but it's going to be 2nd down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a 2nd and 10. To throw again. Fitzpatrick, complete to the running back, Matt Breida. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots' 15-yard line. Giving 23 yards on the pickup. And the Dolphins are going to get a fresh set of downs. Going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's 1st and 10. They run with Breida. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
From the nine, second and five. They run again with Breida. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six. This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak, not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
The Dolphins on third down, they've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This will be third and six. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Another good drive, Charles, but it looks like another that might end in a field goal try.
They've made some nice plays. They've given themselves opportunities. But as you noted, another field goal attempt coming up. And that's not how they want to end drives. They've got to figure out what's the final touch that they need to push it across the goal line.
Yeah, still yet to find the end zone. One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on fourth down. Desperation time, Fitzpatrick on fourth down. And no, it's incomplete. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Patriots defense is gonna take over on down. And they've now made two trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, you're in the red zone. We're thinking we're giving up three. We just want to give up six. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
Cam going to bring the Patriots up now, first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line. And right away, he'll look to throw. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Christian Wilkins showing his strength and quickness there. A loss of 4. Well, they were coming out of the 4-3 defensively. Pressure coming off that right side from the DN.
And that's the blind side of most quarterbacks. If you're right-handed, that's the side you don't see quite as well. And that's why you rely on your left tackle, maybe your highest paid offensive lineman, to take care of you. In this situation, that didn't happen.
Second and 14 as they've got work to do here after the sack. A play fake to Michelle, now Newton. Flushed out right, and he's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. From the gun, here's Newton. He's going to look deep for Edelman, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
The Patriots send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. Unable to corral him, he fights through. It's a return of 4 following a 42-yard punt. And the Dolphins will begin this drive in great field position, first and 10. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Patrick on first down. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Throwing again. Fitzpatrick. They'll set up a screen for Breida. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. They'll throw again. Fitzpatrick. That'll be complete to Breida. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. Down seven, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Jakeem Grant there to make the grab. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Well, the hard part's done. Now they just need to split the post, tie it up, but then their defense is going to have to hold up to send it to overtime.
Yeah, no matter what. I know there's an inclination in it when you have momentum to go for two here, but if you miss it, you don't give your defense a chance at all.
Plus, it's been a good game. I want to see overtime. I'm selfish.
You obviously don't have a flight to catch.
Tomorrow. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. So that drive spanned five plays. And it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Newton. That's complete into the hands of Myers. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Clock running, about to hit 90 seconds to go in the game. Now Newton. And he's got Edelman for the first time. That's complete. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
It's a gain of
give him 9 there on the first down completion. This is where, of course, it's good to have a veteran quarterback under center.
You would just be able to put on one of those blood pressure clips, and nothing would be different for him. He's done it many times before, expects to get it accomplished again.
Newton able to get this to his running back, White. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 16 yards, a first down.
Okay, there's 3 timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Newton to throw. Gets this into the hands of N'Keal Harry. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. They'll run with Michelle, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. The last run got 6, now second and 4. It's Michelle once again. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be 3rd and about a foot or 2. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. So here now is the kicker, Nick Folk. He made his only attempt earlier. This for the win. And his kick is good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And I tell you, when it comes to needing a field goal in closing seconds, pressure situation, there's something to be said for having a veteran kicker trot out there.
Agreed. It's so nice to have someone you can rely on, someone who you know has done it before. And this guy's as cool as they come, isn't he?
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Jakeem Grant now to return. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here.
Today's final score.
So going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hardworking men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. And with that, we sign off from Miami.